Biba Loyola, Biba and Ego. Most of you perhaps know of Loyola, for example, the Ateneo de Manila and Loyola Heights in the Philippines, or Loyola Chicago, or Loyola Marymount in Palo Alto. These are names of colleges and schools in many parts of the world. Loyola is actually the name of a town. It is the birthplace of Ignatius, the founder of the Jesuits. He grew up in a castle and he belonged to nobility. As a young man, while defending his people, he was injured by a cannonball. During his recovery, he read the lives of saints and that of Jesus. And he thought to himself, I want to be a soldier, but not of a nation. I want to be like those saints. I want to be a soldier in the army of Jesus under his banner. After a long period of prayerful conversion and going back to college, he gathered Francis Xavier, Peter Favre, and seven others to form a new group of religious dedicated to spreading the kingdom of God. Within 10 years of their being formed as the Companions of Jesus, or the Jesuits as they are known today, they had established schools throughout Europe and sent missionaries to India and Indonesia and Japan and finally China. I am a Jesuit. I was accepted into this group in 1953, more than 65 years ago. Today, there are over 16,000 Jesuit brothers and priests throughout the world. Some are astronomers, some are missionaries like myself, some oversee caring for refugees, a few are bishops, many are teachers, some are pastors and writers. My cousin Francis on Guam is a video maker, and one Jesuit is a pope, Francis. Another Jesuit who may one day be canonized as a saint is Father Arupe. He grew up in Spain like Ignatius and became the worldwide superior of the Jesuits in the 1970s and 80s. I admired him because in the course of his life as a Jesuit, he served the people in Hiroshima during the bombing in 1944. He had a great sense of humility and humor. He established the Jesuit Refugee Service. But toward the end of his life, the Pope replaced him as superior because what was considered then his radical views, especially towards social help. Later on, he endured a stroke and was unable to speak for the final years of his life. In all of this, like Job, he never cursed God or those who opposed him. Ignatius trained his followers to be like Jesus, even to the point of being humbled and misunderstood like Jesus himself. Father Rupe wrote many articles about the Trinity, devotion to the heart of Jesus, leadership. One of his sayings, which I think reflect his own life, I like very much. He said, "Nothing is more practical than finding God, that is, than falling in love in a quite absolute final way. Fall in love, stay in love, and it will decide everything." Let me end this reflection with a prayer ascribed to Ignatius of Loyola and sung by Jesuits on special feast days and days of renewal of vows. And that's especially today, July 31st, the feast of St. Ignatius of Loyola.
Your love and your grace.